Well, from the report Caitlin gave me, I was expecting you to be in bed. But here you are, upright. Well, standing anyway.
Well, it was good of you to check on me.
Goodness had nothing to do with it, I can assure you of that.
I was just feeling under the weather.
Yes, no doubt you were under something. Wouldn't want you to catch a chill, dear.
Well, I'm feeling better now. Although I'm not quite myself.
Indeed, Olivia. You haven't been quite yourself for some time now, and I'm beginning to wonder whether you will ever be yourself again.
You don't need to worry anymore, Gregory. You can count on it.
I wouldn't count on too much if I were you, darling.
No, why not?
My patience is not unending. You will either straighten things up, or I will be forced to.
You don't frighten me anymore, Gregory.
No? No, this is Gregory Richards. I'd like to talk to Dr. Hammond. Yes, I know what time it is. Let's just see if I can still put a little scare into you, Olivia. Dr. Hammond, yes, I know what time it is. I'm very sorry. I was hoping you could find the time to discuss those procedures again. Yes, regarding the involuntary commitment of a patient into your institution.
Hang up the phone, Gregory.
Yes, oh, I'm sorry. Tomorrow we'll be fine, yes. I'm looking forward to it. Thank you, doctor.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
My goodness, Olivia. You look positively frightened. How did that happen?
You wouldn't dare. Oh, you can't possibly be serious about sending me away.
No?
No.
Your aberrant behavior has made it impossible for you to stay under my roof any longer.
Your roof? What are you saying?
I'm saying that you can't seem to control your lascivious behavior, and since I no longer have the desire to make you control it, I think it's time you sought professional help.
Oh, so shipping me off to some hospital is your way of solving our problems.
Our problems consist of your indiscretions.
Which you caused. You can't stop me just by sending me away, Gregory.
Maybe not, Olivia. But I can destroy you.